Hello YouTube, in this video we have another dumpster PC. And on the front of the PC there's an Intel Pentium 2 sticker. So that makes this system really interesting. The other interesting thing about this system is it has the same case as the dual Pentium 2 overdrive build. Only for the case, it's already an awesome find. The outside of the case is really dirty. I hope it's something like coffee so we can clean it off. Also the CD drives are really yellowed. And we have a floppy drive, the power and reset button, LEDs, a Planholt sticker that was one of the big computer companies of the 90s in the Netherlands. And of course the awesome Intel Pentium 2 sticker. Here we can see some more dirt in the system. Also here in the power supply, so I need to clean it up. And the system comes with a VGA card, a sound card and a modem. So let's open it up. The inside of the case is really dirty, but here we have a Pentium 2 350 MHz and a diamond video card. So I first gonna take my air compressor and blow out all the dust before I even try to start it up or take it apart. The system is much cleaner now, so it's now time to power up the system and see if it still works, and after that I will see what parts are inside. Okay, the system still turns on. And the motherboard is an Intel Shuttle 2 with a 440BX chipset. And that's a really solid motherboard from 1998. And we have a Pentium 2 350MHz CPU, 128MB of memory, a Samsung hard drive, a CD-ROM and a CD writer. And it gives some errors about the date and the time, and I think the BIOS battery is empty. And it comes with Windows 98 pre-installed. The previous owner of this system didn't take any measures to save his data, and he also didn't care about his data because everything is still on the system. I checked his document map and he was probably working in a hospital, and there were also documents about the hospital on the system. So people, if you throw out the system, remove your data or destroy the hard drive, but don't just dump it in a dumpster, because you never know who gets your data. And names and info are in all the documents and all over the system. I gonna swipe this hard drive because I don't want data from others in my home. But people, be careful if you dump a PC if it contains your data, because people are just stupid. The video card is a Diamond Monster Fusion and it's a Voodoo Banshee 16MB card. Always nice to find 3DFX hardware in dumpster machines. I loaded up the Ultimate Boot today. While it was wiping, I used water and soap, and I got the corner of this case much cleaner now, so it's only dirt and not paint or something. So the system will be nicer again when I'm done with cleaning the whole case. I don't gonna use this system as it is now, because I can use the parts for other builds I am planning. Because maybe I gonna use this case for my ideas for a Celeron overclock build. So let's take the machine apart. If you look at the cable management, it did a pretty okay job for a computer that just come from a computer shop. So let's start with the expansion cards. The first card we find is a PCIe SDN modem. Also the system comes with a simple Ansonic sound card with a creative chip. And here we have a Diamond Monster Fusion. It's a 16MB 3DFX Voodoo Banshee. So that's a really nice find in this system. It's always nice to find 3DFX hardware in dumpster machines. 120MB PC100 Siemens memory. Here we have the Pentium 2 CPU, but in the newer case like the Pentium 3's and with an aftermarket cooler. The hard drive is an 8.4 gigabyte Samsung and a Mitsumi 1.44 megabyte floppy drive. Also, we have a nice short floppy cable that comes always handy to make nice clean builds. And two IDE cables, always handy. Here we have a no-name CD-ROM player. And the date on the CD-ROM player is March 99. Also, we have an HP CD Writer Plus, an 8100 series. And it says April 99. So I think this system is a mid 99 build. Also, both of the drives come with the original mounting hardware for the CD drives. So that makes the case nice and complete. The power supply is a Sparkle Power 235 watt unit. It has one 20 pin motherboard connector. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 big Molexen and 2 floppy Molexen. The unit is quite heavy and that's most time a good indication that you have a solid power supply. Here we have the Intel Shuttle 2 motherboard. I built a lot of systems back in 1999 when I was working at a computer shop, because they use mainly Intel boards like this. And also they used, if the customer wanted it, Asus motherboards. And this motherboard is on the same quality level as the Asus P2B and the P3BF series. So it's a really solid motherboard, but really boring, because the BIOS is really simple and no overclocking features. But it has a 440BX chipset, it supports 786 megabytes of memory, an HDP 2 time slot, 4 PCI, 2 ISA, 2 IDE, just a basic solid motherboard. So here you have a departed out Dumpster Pentium 2 PC. So let's see which parts we're gonna keep in the collection. Of course, the hard drive I will keep in my collection, the Futu Benchy. I don't have any plans yet for the motherboard, CPU and memory, but I think I'm gonna keep it as a set, so maybe I can swap it with someone for some other parts, because it's very solid motherboard. Of course, you also get some screws from the system, so that's always a nice bonus. I'm gonna keep this case because I have plans to do a overclock Celeron build and it will fit nicely in this case. Also, the power supply will be used in that build, because it's perfect for it. But I need to really clean the power supply in the case and all the other parts, because there's a lot of dirt in between all the parts and in the slots and stuff. Also, I'm gonna keep the cables, because you can never have enough cables. But the two CD players and the floppy drive, the modem and the sound card will be not in my collection, because the CD drives and even the floppy drives are pretty yellow. The floppy drive looks okay, but this little flap is a different color than the rest, and I have enough floppy drives, so I don't have to keep it. All the modems I throw out of my collection, and this sound card is also really simple. And I have around almost 20 Sound Blaster lives, so there's no need to keep that card. So, thanks for watching. Please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. And please join our retro Facebook group, Retro Machines, so we can build a nice community. See you next time.